a joy we have experienced today as we collaborated across campuses. We spent a whole afternoon singing beautiful choral music, worshiping our Heavenly Father, and learning from each other and from these incredible songs that we've been singing. So this year, as I began to plan this event, I felt led to give our festival the focus of spiritual songs from enslavement times in the American South. So just to give you a very brief history, Negro spirituals are songs that were created by African people who were captured and brought to the United States to be sold into slavery. These stolen people were deprived of their languages, their families, and cultures, but their music could not be taken away. So over the years, these slaves and their descendants adopted Christianity, and they shaped it into a deeply personal way of dealing with the oppression in their lives and the oppression of their enslavement. Their songs, which are now called spirituals, often reflect their faith in the Lord. I think these songs are really incredible songs. I've always loved many of them, and I've been specifically encouraged just by the faith and the hope that are found in them despite the obvious struggles that these people were dealing with. So it is our deep hope tonight that you not only enjoy the songs that you hear, but that you are encouraged by the stories that you'll hear and the faith that is represented in these beautiful songs. So will you pray with me as we get started? Father God, we thank you, Lord, for this night and for this beautiful day. Father, I thank you for the opportunity to gather in your name and to just worship you, Lord. And so I just pray that you would be truly honored and glorified here tonight, that these songs would just bring joy to you, Father, that these kids would be ministered to through these songs, Lord, in these stories. And we just give you this night and ask that you would just truly be mightily glorified. And I pray all of this in your precious name. Amen.
Thank you. There are more than 7,000 spirituals in fragments on record. Born from the experience of unimaginable human pain and grief, these songs give voice not only to a universal aspect of human suffering, but somehow, quite mysteriously and profoundly, express a sincere and believable relationship of joy and praise. As we sing and humbly pay tribute to the unknown creators of these spirituals, we hope you will experience the gift of these songs, which still speak powerfully today.
Work songs used during the early to mid-19th century in the United States to encourage and convey coded information to escaping slaves as they moved along the various Underground Railroad routes. As it was illegal in most slave states to teach slaves to read or write, songs were used to communicate messages and directions about when, where, and how to escape, and warned of dangers and obstacles along the road.
I want to be my maker.
it has generally been born of suffering, yet focused on hope. Hope for a better world, where oppression and suffering give way to freedom and justice. In spirituals and hymns that have grown out of African-American experience, this hope has most often been expressed in terms of a heaven beyond this world, where all will be made right. That vision of hope has never failed, though to stir longings for something better, here now is love. The music of this tradition has made and continues to make a proud heritage of faithful hearers, offering a testimony of hope to all who suffer, enlarging many human hearts through unique poetic power, even just challenging public policy through compelling portraits of a just and free society.
Thank you.
have been working on this for a couple of months, and then these songs are just over and done with like that, because that's how choir works. We spend months working on it, and it's over in about 2 minutes. But we are just so overjoyed to be able to collaborate today and to worship. These kids are tired, can you tell? But they look good, right? They're pulling it off. I'm really proud of them. I just wanted to tell you that our very last song was written by David Crowder. So it's not a traditional spiritual song, but it is written in that style. And I just wanted to read you a quote by him. He says, "There's not a single one of us that can't identify with and understand what it feels like to be shackled and bound to something. We know we're not living in the freedom that we've been given through Christ. This song is so hopeful because our hope is in something as grand as the salvific action of the one and only Son of God. I got to see a physical manifestation of what that looks like, to find physical freedom, and that's what I want for my interior, and that's what this song is all about. My hope is in Jesus." So this is such a great song, you guys. I love this song. We lead this song at church for worship, and it's just one of those songs that really lifts you up, and I thought it would be a great way for us to end our concert tonight. So the song that you're going to hear is not written out music. These kids are making up their parts off the top of their heads. They're really good at that. We practice that in addition to reading notes. I want them to be able to make something up and actually sound good doing it. And they've done a really, really good job of that. So we thank you for being here tonight. I think that we will close with a prayer at the end, but this is our last song. Are you guys ready?
I've been held. afternoon, and it was really a blessing. So I just want to thank the students again for blessing us with the gift of music tonight. I think it deserves one more round of applause.
Gone through so much these past months, but has triumphed